Hello students, welcome to the biology online class. Children, all of you know that we have already completed the discussion of the chapter crop production and management. Today we will discuss about the NCERT exercises. Okay children, so the first question is, select the correct word from the following list and fill in the blank. So here some words are given, that are float, water, crop, nutrients and preparation. Among these words we have to choose the right word to fill the blanks. Okay, now the first question is, the same kind of plants grown and cultivated as a large scale at a place is called. Children, what do you think? What will be the answer among those words? Yes, you are right. The answer will be crop. So that the same kind of plants grown and cultivated on a large scale at a place is called crop. Okay. Now we will go for the next question. The first step before growing crops is dash of the soil. The answer will be preparation. Preparation of the soil. So that is the first step before growing crops is the preparation of soil. Next, damaged seeds would dash on top of water. So children, if you keep many seeds in a on a water, then what will happen? That is, you can see that is a damaged seeds will start to float. So here the answer will be float. Damaged seeds would float on top of water. Next question is, for growing a crop, sufficient sunlight and dash from the soil are essential. The answer will be water and nutrients. So for growing a crop, sufficient sunlight, water and nutrients from the soil are essential. Now we will go to the next question. Next question is matching. Here you have to match the words which are in column A with those in column B. So the first word in the column A is kharif crops. The kharif crops will match with paddy and maize. Children, all of you know the kharif crops are those crops which grow in the rainy season. Okay. Next is rabi crops. Rabi crops means that crops which grows in the winter season. So in winter season, which type of crops can grow? Yes, wheat, gram, pea, that kind of crop. So rabi crops will match with option D, that is wheat, gram, pea. Okay. Next is the chemical fertilizers. So chemical fertilizers will match with B, that is urea and superphosphate. And next is the organic manure. Organic manure means which are obtained from the excretory products of the animals, from the dead, decaying organic matter. These are known as the organic manure. So this organic manure will match with C, that is animal excreta, cow dung, urine and plant wastes. So that means the answer will be kharif crops. Again, I am repeating the answers. Kharif crops will match with paddy and maize. Rabi crops will match with D, that is wheat, gram, pea. Chemical fertilizers will match with urea and superphosphate, whereas organic manure will match with option C, that is animal excreta, cow dung, urine and plant waste. Okay children, now we will go to the next question, that is question number 3. Question number 3 is, give two examples of each kharif crop, B rabi crop. The answer will be, the examples of kharif crops are paddy, maize, etc. Whereas the examples of rabi crops are wheat and pea. Our next question is, Write a paragraph in your own words on each of the following. First one is preparation of soil. Preparation of the soil is the first step in agriculture. Preparation of the soil is done to loosen the soil, which is essential for the root penetration into the soil. This allows the roots to breathe easily. Loosening of the soil allows the growth of earthworms and microorganisms, which will help to keep the soil fertile by adding humus to the soil. Loosening of soil also brings nutrient-rich soil to the top layer, which is essential for the growth of plants. So this is about preparation of soil. The next question is, we have to write about sowing. Sowing is an important process in crop production. First, healthy seeds are selected before sowing. After selecting healthy seeds, sowing is done by either traditional methods or by using equipments, that is seed drill. This tool sows the seed uniformly at a proper distance and depth. The next we have to write about weeding. So for weeding, all of you know weed means it is the unwanted plant which grow in the crop field. Okay. Now removal of unnecessary plants from the field is called weeding. Weeds compete with crop plants for nutrients and water. This will reduce the yield of the desired crops. Weed also interfere while harvesting and gets mixed with the crops. Some weeds are poisonous to animals and humans. Tilling is a common method which helps removal of weeds before sowing crops. Manual methods like physical removal of plants are used to remove weeds. Weedicides are sprayed to get rid of weeds, but this method may affect the health of the farmer because chemicals are used as weedicides. Okay. Our next topic is the threshing. We have to write about threshing also. Process of separating the chaff from the crop is known as threshing. Threshing is carried by a machine which is known as combine, which is a harvester as well as a thresher. Threshing is also done by winnowing, where to blow off wind is used to separate the chaff from crops. Okay, children. Now, our next question is how the fertilizers are different from manure. This is a very important question. You have to learn about the difference between the fertilizers and the manure. So the first point is fertilizers is an inorganic substance. It is a chemical substance, okay, which is manufactured in the factory. Whereas manure is an organic substance. Fertilizers are prepared artificially. Just now I have told you that they are prepared in the factory. Whereas manure is obtained by decomposition of animal, plant and human waste. These fertilizers are prepared in factories, whereas manures are prepared in fields. The fourth point is the fertilizers does not provide humus to the soil, whereas the manures provide humus to the soil. These fertilizers are rich in plant nutrients, whereas the manures relatively contain less plant nutrients. Okay. Fertilizers long-term uses has adverse effect on soil, whereas long-term uses of manure improves the soil fertility. So these are the differences between the fertilizers and manure. Children, you have to learn those points because these are very much important. Okay. Now, children, I want to give you a homework. Okay. So for that, all of you please open page number 10 from your NCERT. Page number 14 from your NCERT book. Please open page number 14 from your NCERT book. In page number 14, you can see that the question number 10. Okay, so this is your question number 10, which is given in your NCERT book, page number 14. The question is, arrange the following boxes in proper order to make a flow chart of sugarcane crop production. So children, already we have learned about the different steps which need to follow for the crop productions. Here the steps are arranged haphazardly. You have to write them in the proper order, okay, and in that way you have to make a flow chart. Now what are the steps are written? In the first box you can see that is sending crops to the sugar factory. In second box irrigation is written. In the third box harvesting. In fourth box sowing. In the fifth box preparation of soil. And in sixth box plowing the field, and in the seventh box manuring is written. So children, you can understand here the different steps for the crop production is written haphazardly. You have to arrange them in the proper order to make a flowchart. Okay children, so you have to do it as your homework. With that, the question number 11, where that is a word puzzle is given, okay, and some clues are given here also. So according to the clues, okay, you have to complete this word puzzle. Okay, so what are the clues I am telling you here? That is, in the down you can see it is written providing water to the crops. Okay, so I think all of you know what is the, that is known as the providing water to the crops. It is, what is the name of that steps? Keeping crop grains for a long time under proper condition, that is the second clue. Okay, certain plants of the same kind grown on a large scale, this is the third clue, which is given in the down. And across the words are a machine used for cutting the matured crop. Second is a rabi crop, that is also one of the pulses. And another one was in a process of separating the grain from chaff. So children, you have to do these things as your homework. In the next class, I will give this solution. Okay, and so that you can check your answer with the solution. So children, today this much. You have to learn all those question answer which is given to you today. And also you have to write this question answer in your copy. Thank you children. Stay safe.